Anger, such a complex emotion. It can harm us, it can hurt us, it can make us feel chaotic, it can serve a purpose, depending on how you harness it and how you manage it. And that's what I'm going to talk about today. How to understand anger, what it does to you, and some tips on how we can make anger work for us and not against us. The first thing we need to understand with anger, though, is that it's an emotion. As we know, anger is an emotion. It's a complex emotion. And managing it is to understand what an emotion is, okay? So we are thinking, feeling, and choosing all day long. That's our mind. The currency of our mind is thinking, feeling, and choosing. And we are always thinking, feeling, and choosing all day long in response to our experiences. That builds thoughts. And all that thought encapsulates the experiences plus the emotions, which are our feelings, because we think, feel, choose, build a thought. And those feelings are built into the thought as emotions. So emotions are an integral part of every experience, which we know. And that's why when we recall an experience, we feel the emotions. Because we've been thinking, feeling, and choosing to build the thought of all the details of the experience. And then we experience that thought. So these thoughts look like trees in the mind. You've heard me explain this before. And if you think of the branches and the leaves being basically how, being like the product of your thinking, how we express ourselves, you could think of the leaves as the emotions, the branches as the details of the experience, and the leaves as the emotions. When we experience an emotion, you have this massive electromagnetic and electrochemical flow through in response in your brain and your body. And that's how we feel our emotions throughout our entire being. So every thought, as I've said over here, has emotional information attached to it. So emotions are information. They're informational signals, informational warning signals, which you work through when you do this app. When you do my neurocycle app, emotions are a warning signal telling you something, like a signal does. It gives you information. Okay, so we can't escape our emotions. Emotions are alive and living and volcanic in nature. They are wired into your mind-brain-body network in the way I've been describing. They give life and vibrancy to those thoughts. They're volcanic in nature. And volcanoes if they're suppressed, they can eventually erupt. And it can be erupting with good stuff, or it could be erupting with bad stuff. And when the lava cools down, then the ground heals, and you actually the grass that grows after volcano erupting is healthier. And the soil is more mineralized after we've had a new volcano erupting than before. So the soil gets improved. So when we manage our emotions, and we don't have to always have them erupting in these volcanic ways, but when it's good to know that if they do erupt, which they will, and we manage that, we can actually then get some good out of that. It can become constructive. So they're volcanic in nature, that they're always like bubbling below the surface. And, you know, if we get little eruptions happening, that's controlled. That's controlling the emotion, so it doesn't create massive lots of damage, and you have to wait more time and do more work to fix it. Okay, so that's the kind of idea. So typical things that make us angry are things like, I mean, this is what research shows: traffic jams, definitely. Arrogant or rude people, for sure. Being yelled at, for sure. Or someone who wastes our time, that gets me. Having to wait too long for something, feeling like we've been used, being lied to, being unjustly punished, wrongfully accused, having too much on our plate, or just plain not dealing with what we're going through. All of those kind of build up in this bubbling way. If we're managing them, the bubbles explode and they're just tiny little volcanoes. Think of those ones you made as a child that didn't really do much, you know, just with bicarb of soda, and they exploded. Think of it when it's managed as being sort of that kind of volcano. But when we don't deal with it, it becomes a full-on eruption. And you can't, you know, you can't get away. They're alive, they're living and dynamic. So I'm sure you can think of a time when you've been justifiably angry, when someone has maybe lied to you, abused you, or shouted at you unjustly or something like that. And then there's also been times probably where you let your anger get the better of you, where you got mad just for like no reason. You just reacted. And so all of those are, as we have that a reaction, our entire mind, brain, body is activated. So we have this incoming information that triggers us, the yelling, the traffic, the being lied to, whatever. And that triggers this reaction. We take that in, we immediately build it to thought because it happens quickly, and we react to it. We like explode. And generally, if there's a pattern of this kind of life coming in, you exploding in a kind of patterned way. So not just now and then, because now and then is totally normal, okay? And things that, you know, there are certain things that you should justify me get angry about. But if you're in a pattern of getting angry, so that the little thing sets you off, or you kind of, the level of the outburst outweighs the stimulation or the trigger. And if that's happening on a regular basis across the board with different things, so it's become a pattern in your life, that's when we're stepping into the volcanic mode of it exploding all over your life and causing damage. And yes, you can eventually do the work and get healed or whatever, but we should be proactive and preventative, because that pattern of angry outbursts, which means that there's an increased frequency on a regular basis, that's the problem. So the occasional angry outbursts, okay, the justifiable anger, those are good, because those are managed. Those are the things that actually can work for us. As I mentioned up at the beginning, they can be helpful, but they can serve a purpose. That was the wording I was looking for. You know, that's okay, but it's when it becomes a frequent pattern and you can start feeling the difference. So for example, this happened in my life recently, and I'm generally not an angry person. Sure, I get irritable and I have angry outbursts, but not as a regular thing in how I function. I'm pretty controlled about that. But I noticed just recently I was just about to go to sleep, and I just happened to check my email. I don't know why I did that just before I went to sleep. But anyway, normally I read a book or something like that. And I was suddenly got so frustrated because I saw a bunch of emails that I needed to answer. And when I scanned them, I thought, darn, I didn't do this. And then I'm going to have to do this now. And I'm going to have to get out of bed, and I'm relaxed, and I want to go to sleep, and I'm tired, and I'm pumped. And I exploded. I mean, I'm saying it gently now, but I got so mad. Tell you what came out. I had a few little choice words that popped out of my mouth and got totally frustrated and irritated. And my poor dogs that were fast asleep on the bed, and my husband, who had just fallen asleep, both, all of them just like sat up and, what's going on? You know, what's happening? And, you know, just the level of the kind of intensity of my reaction was quite a shock. And, you know, my husband actually commented and said, you know, are you okay? You know, this is happening, once I calmed down, not while I was still mad, said, you know, this is happening quite often. And, you know, at that moment, I wanted to react again with another angry outburst. But what he said struck me, and I started thinking, okay, and I asked him, is this happening often? Because I can feel like I feel awful. And we'll talk about why we feel so awful in a moment. And he honestly told me that, yeah, you're getting angry often. And, you know, as I thought about it, and he said, much more than normal, and like for the slightest thing seems to set you off. And so I just, you know, thought about it for a little bit while they all fell back asleep, and I apologized, obviously, and, you know, attended to the emails that were urgent, and, you know, because very often when I do work, it'll kind of calm me down, and did that. And then I thought about this, and I thought, okay, well, let me do what I have told my patients to do, what I know I should do. And, you know, and I, because the level of frustration and negativity shocked me. So, and I realized, you know, this is becoming a pattern in my life. And yes, I do have a lot on my plate, and I did at that time when this happened. And yes, that may be an excuse for my behavior, but, you know, it's never an excuse to always be angry that it's starting to affect other people. It's starting to affect how you're functioning. And it's not healthy in the short or the long term. So in that moment, I did what I recommend people do, and it needs to help my patients do. And so I did this. I stopped. I metaphorically stood back and observed myself and my behavior. And I just cast my mind back to the day, to the week that had passed, to the month that had passed. And then I found myself tracking back to another month behind that. So kind of like almost 9 to 10 to 12 weeks that I thought, that's when it started. And I tracked it back to an event that had happened in my life at that stage that was very overwhelming. And I, you know, was still maybe processing it and that sort of thing. And I realized, oh gosh, that before that it was more like angry outbursts now and then. But from that definitely was a little bit of an origin story there. And that was coming out in these angry outbursts. So I rewound back to when the release began. I looked for the potential origin. And then I started looking at the triggers. What's triggering me? I found that there were quite a few triggers. And I looked at the frequency that it was happening multiple times a day or whatever and so on. And I recognized I needed to change because this was affecting me. It made me feel awful. So let's talk about what anger does. And then we'll talk about some tips about how I change that and how you can change it. So anger primes our body for the fight or flight response, which is good because that results in for good anger. It gets us ready to solve a problem, run away, whatever it may be. And this initial fight and flight response, if it's in a good stress zone, it's going to be helpful for us. So this is what happens. The adrenal glands release a flood of stress hormones like adrenaline and cortisol in the body. The brain shunts blood away from the gut towards our muscles in preparation for physical exertion. Our heart rate and blood pressure will increase and our breathing becomes more rapid in preparation for that flight or fight response or both. And then you also get a rise in body temperature and increase in perspiration. Okay, so these happen pretty quickly with an angry outburst. Now, this is okay in a short burst if it's healthy anger because it kind of sharpens our mind, sharpens our wits so that we can achieve a goal, we can defend ourselves or defend an unjust attack or defend that person, yourself from that person yelling at you or lying to you. Kind of revs us up like you rev a car, so to speak. And this response can help us to channel that energy in a productive way. However, if it's unhealthy anger, which is what mine was becoming because of the frequency and how many things I was responding to, or things like road rage, getting into road rage, or anger that is left unmanaged over time, this flight and fright or fight response becomes very distorted. So instead of working for us, it works against us. And it releases instead of spurts of flood chemicals, stress chemicals happening in a way that's good and balanced and helps you to focus. It's like a flood, an ongoing flood, and that wears down your hypothalamic pituitary axis over time, and that's not good. So the key here, and that affects the chemicals that are released in our body, it affects metabolic changes, can cause harm to different systems and so on. So the key here is frequency. One or two occasional outbursts, and I'm stressing this, won't cripple you and maybe even be necessary at times to put you into positive stress so that you can solve a problem or be alert and aware if someone's maybe abusing you emotionally or something like that. It's frequency over time is what we have to watch out for. Okay, frequency over time is what we want to watch out for. So one or two angry outbursts a day over several weeks, around 63 days, can create an established habit, and that's what had happened to me. Or negative coping mechanism. So instead of it helping me, it had become a negative coping mechanism. So now research shows that because emotions and cognition, so you think, feel, choose, and you build that thought, that's the emotion and the cognition, are so dynamically linked to our body. You build the network in your mind, brain, body. So emotion and cognition are so dynamically linked to body arousal, the mind, brain, body, which is the mind, brain, body connection. When we are angry, even on that non-conscious level, this will affect how our mind, brain, and body prioritize the resources, okay? Favoring action at the expense of clear thinking. So you're going to do or whatever in response instead of thinking it through. Okay, so it's maybe yell, shout, cause a fight, react quickly, get irritated. Like I did, woke up the dogs and everyone. The attention and visual processing areas of the brain will get much more active. So the attention and visual processing, but in a distorted way, and that affects overall brain health. So it can, more specifically, you have an area of the brain called the amygdala. I'm sure you've heard of it. It's like an emotional library, like a library holds all of our, or holds books. The amygdala holds is a library holding our emotional perceptions. So it's the whole emotional package, like in a little book, of our memories, of our experiences that are packed into thoughts. Memories are packaged into thoughts. And it also holds the associations between them. So between experiences and emotions. So it holds the emotional perception plus the link between the emotion and the actual experience. Okay. And it goes into overdrive and overactive state. This is kind of a bit like if you imagine running through a library and just knocking and grabbing books illogically all over the place. And just like, you know, it's just like chaos. It's and you're knocking books over. So that, you know, it's not, there's no logic. You're not thinking clearly. And you can't really process the emotions and the experiences and so on. So that is, when that happens, that is actually not good for the mind, brain, and body. So let's see what happens. In the heart, Frequent and angry outbursts can literally harm our blood vessels, okay, of the heart, and that increases our risk for heart disease. So when blood vessels are harmed, that increases our risk for heart disease. So this happens because the uncontrolled anger causes the angry outburst, causes an increase in a burst of stress chemicals, specific ones, such as hormones like, I'm going to say this right, catecholamines, okay, which increase blood pressure. So stress hormones called catecholamines increase, and that therefore increases blood pressure, and that contributes to the development of artery clogging plaques in the blood vessels, and that can lead to heart disease, okay, coronary heart disease. However, even a sudden surge of catecholamines during a fit of anger, that's really bad. I mean, you hear people having a fit of anger and having a heart attack, can literally cause heart attacks. It can cause lethal heart rhythms or rapid weakening of the heart muscle. And that's a condition known as cardiomyopathy. Stress cardiomyopathy, when you have that sudden burst and you have this sudden surge of these hormones, and then that stresses the rhythm of the heart and the heart tissue. In our GI gut, our gastrointestinal system, our GI, also really sensitive to emotions. I'm sure you've experienced that. And it's also connected, the gut's very connected to our hypothalamus, which is called literally known as the brain of the brain. And that is like, I often explain it like a chemical factory where it's controlling all the chemicals that are going into the various different things. Okay, so it basically, when we have an angry outburst, this connection between the hypothalamus and the brain, the chemical factory, and the GI tract, it connects and it sends this very fast, impactful message. And then that can basically impact how the GI tract functions. It causes inflammation in the gut. It can also create like little breakages in the lining of the gut into which waste and food and things can get in. And that combination can cause irritable bowel syndrome and bloating and gas and gurgling. And when how many times have you been in a state where you've had an angry outburst and you've immediately got this sore stomach, okay? Or suddenly your stomach's bloated, okay? Such real. So we're seeing more and more research on the connection between emotional mind and GI states. So to say it's worth catching those angry outbursts is really, really worth it, because it's your heart, your GI system, your brain, inflammation in your brain, all the things I've been saying. So you want to, we need to do it. It's an understatement to say we need to manage our angry outbursts. We just set ourselves up for kinds of issues. And of course, it's easier said than done. When you're in the midst of an angry outburst, like, it's really hard to calm down. Yes, I told you I calmed down, but the times before I didn't, it was like I'd kind of reached a peak where I started seeing the impact. And, my husband told me, he said there's an impact and so on. So sometimes you'll notice it yourself and you'll be able to do it. Sometimes it takes someone else to tell you, hey, cool it. You seem to be angry lately. So let's see what you can do. So let's talk about some tips that you can do. First of all, observe if it's a pattern or a one-off. If it's a one-off, it's okay. If it's the pattern like I described, then you need to do something about it. So you can ask yourself some questions. Things like, how often are you having the angry outburst? Is it daily? Is it multiple times a day? Is it almost daily? Is there a particular time in the day that this happens? Is there a particular person or place or situation when these angry outbursts get triggered? Or is it just happening all the time with anything? Have people commented that you seem angry and more irritable than normal? Has there been some unexpected change in your life recently that has upset you and you haven't maybe dealt with and potentially could be making you feel out of control, and anger is the distorted coping mechanism that you have developed to try and deal with it? So you can write this down. You can pause this, answer those questions, write this down, and keep a track of what you're observing.